In this video, we are going to use the joints tool in Autodesk Inventor to assemble some components in the assembly environment. To begin with, I want to place this bracket onto this base, so I'll select the joint tool located here on the Assemble tab in the Relationships panel. In the Place Joint dialog box, I can select the type of joint that I want. In this case, I want a rigid, which is not going to allow the parts to move at all. I can also keep it on automatic, and it usually does a pretty good job of selecting the type of constraints that I want based upon the types of objects I select. Next, I'll come into my objects, and the first click is going to be the object that's going to move. So the base is already in place. I'm going to come to the other component first. You'll notice that I can select faces and edges, and simultaneously it'll highlight a point and give me a little circular shape as well. So this indicates the points that are going to go together, and also the way in which they're going to go together. So I'm going to begin by selecting this edge right here. You can see the way this circular shape was right in the middle of this part. I'm going to go and select the corresponding point on the part. And it's important that I don't select it here where it's laying down. I want to select it here where it's corresponding to the other one. As you can see, it brings the part in. The little shaking there is the indication that it's a rigid part. And then obviously it's not quite oriented properly, so I have a couple of flip and orientation buttons I can use. That one obviously is bringing it down, so I'll select the invert to bring it back to the side that I want, then click OK. And as you can see, it is rigid. I cannot move it away. Similar to constraints, if I take a look at my model tree, I will see my joints here. So I'll place another one very similarly, but I'll use a different one this time. This time I'll actually click on that bottom plane. Then on the base, I will click the same point and orientation. And again, I might have to flip it one way or the other to get it to go where I want. Next, we'll look at a cylindrical example. I'm going to place this axle inside these holes, so I will use my joint tool. Then I will go ahead and select the type here as cylindrical. With the cylindrical, it's going to be able to rotate and translate as well. So I'm going to begin by selecting the middle point here of this cylinder. Then to start with, I'm just going to select the inside of this bracket here. So that's going to line up the middle of the axle with that edge. I'll go ahead and click OK. As you can see, it's allowed to rotate and translate. And sometimes it's necessary to go ahead and add some constraints as well. So to get this one fully locked down, I am going to go ahead and add a mate constraint as well. I'm going to locate the XY plane of the axle and the YZ plane of the assembly and put those together. So constrain XY of the axle, YZ, okay. Now it's just free to spin. Next, I'm going to bring the wheel in. So I'll use my joint tool again. This time I am going to choose the rotational. So no longer will I have the translational part of that. For this one, I want to get the very center of this cylinder inside here. So you might have to move around a little bit to get exactly what you want. There's the center one. Then I want to get the center of this cylinder. As you can see, they line up and I now have the rotation action. I can go ahead and click OK. And you can see it is constrained, but it still has the ability to revolve. I'll use the same tool to locate one of these fasteners here. So once again, I'll use my joint, rotational. I'll select the bottom of this, very similar to an insert constraint, and the surface there. Once more, it's free to rotate around. I can click OK. This one's going to be a little easier to see the rotation than the other shapes were. If I locate this particular one in the model browser, here's the rotational, I can right click on the joint and I can lock it. So that will actually turn off the ability to rotate. You can see the little padlock on the symbol down here. Of course, if I wanted to do that, I might as well just do a rigid joint. So I'll choose my joint tool, rigid, and then I will select the same locations. And this time I have it rigid from the start, so it is not allowed to rotate. That concludes this look at joints in Autodesk Inventor.